Well, good day from Washington, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Robert Christian Show, and you are our guest today. But do I ever have some news for you and some insight that I'm going to go over? And asking the an ageless question as to where do we stand as Americans these days. Some good news, however, for Democrats. Their odds of winning the House are now officially above 50% for the first time. With less than 100 days before the November elections, eight races are labeled leaning Republican, while many others have shifted into toss-up positions. It's going to be interesting to see how this plays out. The midterm elections, this year, it is going to be one of the most vital and one of the most crucial midterm elections ever in American history. And it would be a great idea for everybody to get on board with this and for everybody to figure out, you know what, it is time to get off my butt. It's time to get up. It's time to go to the polls. And maybe it is your first time to vote. We welcome you to the polls. If you are an absentee voter, please make sure that you get your ballots in on time. It is absolutely vital. We have seen and had, what, the last 18 months of a freight train disaster in Washington, D.C. when it comes to our elected officials and when it comes to the political mess that we see that America is in today. Something has to change.
The Robert Christian Show, addressing issues that matter.
Let's start looking at a solution. It may be shocking to you.
And now, your host, Robert Christian.
And thank you once again, Maestro. It's great to have the same Maestro every week, every day on the live shows. I think that's awesome, don't you guys? All right, let's jump into this. And let's get some facts laid out first, and let's see where we end up. Every show is different. Every show it is a challenge. Every show is a journey. I guess maybe even through one's mind, because I like to bring up issues and things that do matter, and you matter the most. As an American, as a taxpayer, as a voter, you do matter. The Commander-in-Chief, the disapproval rating has hit an all-time high of 60%, according to a new Washington Post ABC News poll that was put out today, actually. Only 36% of those polls said that they approve of Donald Trump's performance in the White House. 36%. I'm really kind of shocked that it is that many. ABC News noted that Trump's average approval ratings since he entered the White House is the lowest of any modern president since the 1940s. But yet in a tweet, the almighty tweet, the tweet is more powerful than the pen, at least it appears so these days. Over 90% approval rating for your all-time favorite, in quotation, I hope, ex quote, president within the Republican Party. And 52% overall, Trump tweeted, despite all of this being made up stories by the, in quotation, fake news media, and endlessly trying to make me look bad as an evil as possible, look at the real villains, please. So he said, a poll released by the Wall Street Journal and NBC News last week found Donald Trump had a 44% approval rating and a 52% disapproval rating among general voters. it is time for people to wake up and to start looking at some of these even generic polling that has been done. We see what is going on, and the polls, they are a good temperature check as to really kind of what's going on, what the American people like and what they don't like. It is a great temperature check for our politicians to pay attention to it. Am I doing well or am I not doing well? What are the polls suggesting? So if a politician was to want to be upright and want to do a good job for America, they would be paying attention to them. What is it that I am missing as a politician? What is it that I'm missing that the American people want? Or what they are screaming about, or what their heartstrings are. What is this? Because that is going to be the ultimate difference between a low poll rating or a high one. Interesting. Can't you say amen? I had to put that in there. Come on. It's Friday. A poll released by the Wall Street Journal last week said that Trump had a 44% approval rating, and now it's down to 36. Friday's poll found that only 78%, that's today's poll. Interesting. Friday's poll found that even among Republicans, only 78% gave Trump his efforts in the White House a great big thumbs up. Good going. Only 78%. The survey also found that half of the public back Congress initiating impeachment proceedings against Donald Trump. Now, do you think that's a good idea at this juncture or not? What do you think? The stunning poll numbers come after a flurry of legal activity in Trump's inner orbit. And I tell you, if there's an inner orbit, he must be on the moon himself. Last week, his former personal attorney, Michael Cohen, pled guilty to campaign finance violations and implicated that Donald Trump in a scheme to pay off women during alleged affairs. His former campaign chairman, Paul Manafort, was also convicted of tax fraud and bank fraud and support for special counsel Robert Mueller's investigation now stands strongly at 63%. Folks, this is the truth. These are the poll numbers. Trump attempts to discredit the probe. 52% of Americans strongly support the federal inquiry into Russian election interference and possible connections between the Trump team and the Kremlin. Trump has repeatedly attempted to smear Mueller and his entire team of investigators by painting them as a politically biased and frequently referring to the investigation as a witch hunt. The fact does not lie. What you see with your eyes, you can believe it. What you hear with your ears, could it be the truth? According to the new poll, 61% of Americans believe that Cohen's administration or our admissions are true. Now, all of this, folks, it is to bring us to the point that I'm going to be making here shortly. Now, I will continue. I will continue this opener. According to the new poll, 61% of Americans believe that if Cohen's admissions are true, Trump broke the law. 53% also think that Trump has obstructed Mueller in the investigation in some kind of way. Also troubling for Donald Trump is that the majority of Americans, i.e. 66%, oppose a pardon for Manafort. Even among Republicans, 45% are against the idea. Now, in my personal thought about this, if Donald Trump did pardon Manafort, if he pardoned Cohen for any and all activity, in this case, that would be an abuse of power. Hence, it could be construed or it could be understood then or thought of as an impeachable offense. Now, I know that the Republican Party, the GOP, they would sit back with their eyes shielded, with their ears closed, with the mouth wide open, like a gaping hole, and say, "Oh, I can't believe that. I just can't believe that." You know, that would not be an abuse of power. That would be a direct issuance from the White House, really. And how can it be? I mean, come on, Rudy Giuliani. He said, "Well, you know, Trump hasn't done anything wrong. He hasn't lied. He hasn't obstructed. It's a witch hunt." All right, we've heard this. But folks, let me say this as plainly as that I can. The bottom line is that the truth is always going to be the truth. What is fake, what isn't right, is not going to stand the test. What we have is an absolute dilemma on our hands, but it can be fixed. Absolutely. It can be repaired at the poll, at least for the majority of this. So we are in a crossroads of either are we going to simplify things, go to the poll and vote. Go vote with our mind, go vote with a conscience, go vote with a heart, or are we going to vote for somebody because we feel sorry for the other party? A party line vote, it's a disaster. And folks, we are seeing a very disgruntled form of governance in America today, and even the Constitution is being stretched to points that it has never been challenged before. This is not the norm. This should not be received as to be the norm. We should not think that it is the norm. We should have our eyes open. We should have our ears open. We should have our heart opened, that we can see the handwriting on the wall, the disaster that is at hand, and do something about it. Now, surely I know that there are a more than a handful of people that think this way. Well, it's my vote, and I'm just not going to choose to vote. I'm going to choose to stay out of it. Politics has never been my forte, or I don't understand it, or you know, okay, so things are kind of going south a little bit. Oh, but look at the economy. Yes, let's look at the economy. As of 2 days ago, Donald Trump had said that he wanted to freeze the federal government workers from any pay raise to the tune of 2.1% increase in pay. And he said because that is a result because there isn't enough money in the coffers to pay for it. But yet, he gave $1.5 trillion easy peasy to the super wealthy, to the rich, to the millionaires, the billionaires in America and to corporate America. But yet, and he's shoring up their pocketbook. Let me tell you something. Just in case you may have forgotten, the Ronald Reagan trickle-down economic policy never did work. It wasn't designed to work. What Trump is doing, first, he is not representing you and me. He's representing his own personal interest. And when he is caught up in something that isn't true, then he makes something up to cover that made-up story. And the story, the saga, continues on and on and on and on. And you don't know which way is up or really what to believe. So I say, don't believe it, period. We see the disaster, but all right, but I'm waiting. I'm waiting patiently for the President of the United States to stand up, to be voted into office, to be put there by the American people, somebody that brings our country together in unity, somebody who has the balls to stand up to the corruption and say enough. Get it right or you're gone. Get it right or else. Here's the ultimatum. But the ultimatum never should really come from the office of the president, but it should come from the voters. Did you know that? So we as voters, we have power. We have great power in our vote. So what is taking people so long to wake up? Well, I think that it is because they don't want to believe what is going on. They look at what's happening and they say, oh, okay, well, that's just part of the witch hunt. That's just part of the evildoer standing up against, and I've heard this in quotation, God's chosen one. X quote. God put him into office. Nah. And then they try to sound holy. They try to make it sound a little bit spooky, too. But we're seeing an absolute disaster. But the cool thing is, and there could not have been a better time for all of this mess to be coming out and for our Constitution to be challenged the way that it has been in the last 18 months. This is why. Stay tuned. The reason why is simple, because the midterm elections this upcoming November, it is going to set the stage. Either we are going to accept what's going on right now as, in quotation, the new norm, X quote, hashtag that, would you please? Or we are going to revolt against that as Americans and say no. This isn't the norm. We can do better than this. This is not a good thing. And thus, take our aggravation, take our message to the poll, and vote out these yahoos that have been in office for 30, 40 years, and put into office people that have America's heartbeat as their own. They understand the breadbasket of America. They understand the farmers of America, the ranchers of America. They keep America and the world fed to begin with. Secondly, you're going to be looking at what politicians have been passing lackluster sweetheart of deals for the super wealthy, for the corporate America, to give them the multi-billion dollar contracts and tax breaks and all. But what about the average Joe? What about using that money to sustain Social Security for years to come? Or using that same amount of money to fund education for every American that seeks a higher education? What about setting aside that much money to help with public housing, to retrofit and to upgrade our school systems in the U.S., to rebuild our highways, our crumbling bridges, and our railroads? What about that? Now, no, it's not going to be a win for all money, falling off of every tree in the backyard, just for some. But it's only only the wealthy who have been able to get that kind of tax break or tax relief. But the average American, oh, no. Folks, this is the time of any other time that we need to start looking at what some of these politicians have voted for. What have they done? What is their record? Is their record straight up? Have they been more honest than not? Are they standing up for your best interest and mine? Are they representing the United States properly? Or is it swindled with improper conduct, with hate, with disgust, with greed, with division? Messages that are extremely divisive and not messages that bring America together in unity. Sure, we can look at all of this stuff, and sure, we should be well versed enough to figure it out. We should be well versed enough to look back and say, you know what, wait a second. No, I'm not doing this anymore. These crayons that are in Washington, I voted for them over and over and over and over. I've stood the test. I've stood up for them. I've stood up. Wait a second. No, it hasn't worked very well, then, has it? The way that I personally see it is that the majority of our lawmakers have become so far distant from what the reality is on Main Street, not Wall Street. They're well attached to that. But where you live, how you live, what you do for a living, your money woes, your financial despair in some cases, this is not right. Having a government that is not for the people, by the people. Here lately, it is a government for the government, by the government, and that's it. It's sad. And now we have the potential for a very troubling time because 66%. The majority of Americans oppose any pardon deals for Manafort. And 45% of Republicans say that they're also against the idea. When it comes to Trump's dispute with Jeff Sessions, 62% of respondents backed the former Alabama senator. Donald Trump has publicly berated Sessions for recusing himself from the Russian probe, which eventually led to Mueller's appointment. The thing of it is that Jeff Sessions, the attorney general, he is not Donald Trump's personal lawyer. He is the attorney general. He is the one who oversees the Department of Justice. And now we have threats on either side. We have threats that if the Democrats win the midterms, then it's going to be chaos. We've heard it on the other side that it is going to be chaos if it's just throw the cards up in the air to see where they fall. But either way that it goes, Trump said that he would not fire Jeff Sessions, at least not before the midterms. Jeff Sessions did what was right when he recused himself of the Russia investigation. He did himself a favor and he did America a favor. Because as the Attorney General, he cannot be pardoned. He can't have a pardonsome mindset and think, okay, well, everything has to be Republican now, or everything has to be Democratic now, or based on Tea Party ideas and agendas. And that's just, no. He did what was right. Now, could it be because perhaps Jeff Sessions himself is a little bit too close to the issue at hand? Or is he too far away from it? What do you think? This is something else. Absolutely something incredible. 64% also opposed the idea of Trump firing Sessions. Now, the poll was conducted with 1,003 adults that are voters. The margin of error was 3.6%. Now, I said all that to ask you again, where do you think that we stand? Do we stand? Oh, hello, Sharon. Hello, Jane. Love you guys dearly. Miss you. But where do you stand? Now, look, we have heard the disgrace. We have heard words uttered from the Oval Office that are not becoming of a president. And words that you would hear perhaps from a dictator. We have heard things come out of the White House that you would maybe think that would only happen, or that you would only see during a Hollywood blockbuster movie. Point. This is not a blockbuster movie. Point. This is a disgrace. This is horrifying. Point. Your and my vote this upcoming election period, it is going to be the most vital, the most crucial than ever before in the history of voting in America. Why? Because, A, we're either going to say yes to a tyrant and say, yes, this is acceptable. This is the new norm, and I'm fine with that. And I'll place my vote behind it. Or B, we are going to say, or two, we're going to say, oh, no. This isn't going to work. Because this isn't for America. This man, he is not for America. This man, what he is doing, he is sheltering those that are around him that pledge allegiance to him. Sharon says that she thinks that Jeff Sessions should be Trump's puppet. Well, perhaps maybe he is. Maybe. We're going to get into that, folks, when we return. This is the Robert Christian Show. Don't go away. There is more to come right after this. Lord have mercy. I'll tell you what, folks. It's going to be interesting. Let's just see how this plays out. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, right after this. Don't go too far.